Ridge Bulletin, all the upcoming events, everything going on here at the church. We got a lot of great things. Tonight, of course, we got awesome service. Come on back for our 6 o'clock service. Jason has got an amazing word. He's one of my favorites. And so he's got a great word he's going to be bringing tonight for that. Don't forget about the barbecue today after the service. If you brought a visitor, make sure they go over to the visitor center and get a free coupon for a free hamburger, hot dog, all the goodies for the family. And, you know, today is Visitor Appreciation Sunday, and so enjoy it. But I encourage you, hot dogs are $1, hamburgers are like $1.50. Buy them up, get some for Christmas, I don't know, give them gifts, but that's cheap, that's good stuff. And enjoy, but fellowship, you know, this is family. Make the time to have some great relationships, meet some new people, sit out there and enjoy.
Yeah, and what it says here is present the ticket to the Visitor Center and receive $20 gift. And a barbecue coupon.
I like the voice. Now you're like not supposed to, you were just coming, you weren't supposed to talk.
Oh, okay.
You can't, you can try. How's your voice?
Great.
Good.
Healed. I just want to mention New Believers Foundation class. anyway, it's at 9:15 if you want to get to understand the foundations of what you believe. I really encourage you to come to the class. I'm teaching it, and I'd love to get to know you, too.
All right, that's New Believers. Yesterday, we had the Single Moms Christmas Party, which we as a church put on. You were part of putting that on. Had over 100 single moms blessed yesterday. I know of, now listen to this. You can clap after this because this is exciting. I know of over 10 of the single moms through Facebook and testimonies and talking to people who said that they hadn't been to church in years, but this touched their lives, and they're going to become regular attenders here at Living Word Bible Church.
Amen. Dr. Tom is going to be speaking.
Right? Give a big hand clap for your pastor.
Same voice.
Mary, I'm home. Oh, hey, honey.
Hey, Joseph. How's your day?
Oh, it was great. I was working with Zachariah over there, working on his deck.
Yeah?
Doing pretty good.
How's he doing?
Oh, he's doing a lot better now that he can actually talk. It makes things a lot easier.
Yeah. Well, what do you have there?
Just the mail. Let's see. Junk. Junk. Oh, I got a newsletter. That's good. Census? That's what this is all about. Bethlehem.
Bethlehem? Well, as long as after the baby's born.
Yeah. When was the baby due again?
That's my team. They come up with fun stuff. Bless God, you can tell Maureen and I are living in the same house. She said, all night long in my sleep, I'm saying, you ain't taking my voice. I'm going to have a voice. Well, I got a voice, but made it through 3 or 4, whatever it is so far. Amen. Everybody ready for the word today? Good. You heard about Ole. He bought an AM radio. Took him about a month to figure out he could listen to it at night. Somebody told me they invited Ole to church. I thought I'd have to change the names, but anyway. Well, what is celibacy? Celibacy can be a choice in life or a condition imposed by circumstance. While attending a marriage weekend, Kurt and his wife, Leanne, listened to the instructor declare it is essential for husbands and wives to know the things that are important to each other. He addressed the men and said, can you name and describe your wife's favorite flower? Kurt leaned over and touched Leanne's arm gently and said, gold medal all-purpose, isn't it? And thus began Kurt's life of celibacy. Okay, it's a tough crowd. I can tell that without question. We're talking about light, love, and life. And we're going to talk about love today, and over the next 3 weeks, we'll cover these as we walk our way into this Christmas season. It is a wonderful time of the year. I love this time of the year. You can actually experience the love of God. The whole world senses something different in the air. There's something different on the freeway. There's something different at the malls. Something different at the grocery stores. There's something different in homes. And the reason for that is that people start taking on an attitude of giving, which is the attitude of love. And so more and more love is released as energy into the surrounding atmosphere, and we can feel it. You can feel a greater sense of love this time of the year. It's a wonderful, wonderful time of the year. I think about those that are in the process of trying to change Christmas titles or Christmas parades to holiday parades. Isn't that amazing? And everybody gets all upset about it, but I don't get upset about it. The reason I don't get upset about it is because Christ's Mass is one thing, but when you call it a holiday, it comes from the word holy day. And if there ought to be a holy day, it would be the day of birth of Christ. So in their absolute ignorance, they have made it a more special day. To me, that makes good sense. It is a holy day. It is a very special day that we celebrate Christ Jesus and what God did in sending His love to this earth because He loved the world so much. It's absolutely awesome. I was also thinking that just 10, 12 years ago, if we'd had a Christmas tree on stage, people had been most upset. Well, it looks to me like we got about 20 on stage now. But I want you to know that if I see anybody bowing down and worshiping a Christmas tree, we will exit you out of here. You know, religion's a strange thing, isn't it? Religion does strange things. Truth is what we live our lives by, not by religion. Amen? Bless God. Well, open your Bibles up to 1 John. Lord, I ask that you help me as I teach today that I might bring truth and life, and the very wisdom of God. Lord, it's not my words, but it's all about what you have to say to the hearts of your people. And we'll give you praise and we'll give you glory. And Lord, you minister the understanding today about the very power of the love of our God. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, in 1 John and chapter 4, verse 7, let's read there. It says, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God," that's born again, "and knows God. And he who does not love does not know God, for God is," somebody help me, "God is what?"
Love.
God is love. That's kind of an interesting thought, because many times you could read that 1,000 times and not really get a whole lot out of it other than say, oh, God is love. But let's think about it for a few moments. If God is love, then I want you to imagine how much power must be in love. If God is holding this universe together by His most powerful word, if God spoke, and we believe Genesis, and He said, "Let there be," and there is continuing to be new universes birthed continually as we build bigger and bigger telescopes. We are discovering further and further out into space, millions of light years away, more universes being birthed and stars suddenly appearing, because God's word is just getting there. When God spoke, he didn't cut it off and stop it. So it tells you that the word just continued. We're worried about whether they're aliens or not. God didn't create man. He made him out of dirt. Hello. So I'm not worried about aliens out there. Okay. But think about the power that must be in love. Now we know that Christ, according to John chapter 1, it says that Jesus is the light and the life of man. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So we know that he is light and life, but we know that God's divine nature is love, light, and life. So we know that in John chapter 3, verse 16, it says, for God so loved the world that he did what? Gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe on him might have eternal life. So when God sent Jesus, God sent his love. For God so loved the world, he sent his love. So his love is Christ. Christ is the Word become flesh and dwelt among us. And God infused then his love in this book. And this book is filled with and infused with the very faith of God, the very power of God, and the love of God that holds the universe together, that when we believe it, we can move mountains. When we believe it, we can bring healing to our bodies. When we believe it, we can change our poverty situation to prosperity. We can change every circumstance we're ever confronted with this power. But it is the power of love. That's really what it is. It's really the power of love. Yet, why do we wrestle so hard with loving? It's quiet. No greater love has any man except that he lay down his life for another. Is that correct? Jesus did that. So there must be something about coming out of self and being willing to lay down our lives for one another, because that would be the greatest form of love. Think about the power of love. I was thinking about it. I saw a 15-year-old girl, braces on her teeth. Woo! Lord, God. She was the apple of my eye. And I fell into this power of love. And this power of love through the years has developed to where, when we got married, I was taking on a responsibility of another life and saying, I am now responsible to provide and protect a gift that God had given to me. So now I had the responsibility to lay down my life, to work